Why am I running around like my tail is on fire? This is the best time to raise human consciousness. We have a window of 15 to 30 years in my opinion.
You've been traveling, talking, speaking, connecting on an incredible basis. You've used the digital medium, you've connected with youth. You seem to be on a roll and a drive. You want to spread your message very quickly. What is your purpose now in the way you are connecting globally and in India?
Well, why am I running around like my tail is on fire? Is because, see, this is the first time in the history of humanity, this is the first time when our survival process is so well organized. I just want you to look back and see, 100 years ago, if you had to get your morning, let's say a bucket of water, you had to walk a mile and carry a bucket of water. Today, most people are not fit to carry a bucket of water for a mile. So, if you have a little bit of money, you can buy everything that you need for 1 month and stay in your house and your survival is taken care of. Never before human survival was so well organized. All the time we've been struggling with survival, survival is well organized. And for the first time, we can communicate to the whole world. Many great beings have come in the past. Let's say Krishna came, when he spoke, 25 people could not hear. A Buddha came as a gentle being, if he spoke, probably 10 people could not hear properly. Today we can sit here and talk to the entire world. If we do not change the consciousness of the human creature in this generation, that means we are not interested. So this is the moment, because this is the first time survival is well organized and our ability to communicate is like never before. If we cannot raise human consciousness now, we can never do it. What is the significance of raising human consciousness? See, it's like this. When it comes to what is mine and yours, this is my body, that's your body, this is my mind, that's your mind, we may agree on a few things, disagree on some things, but what consciousness means is a dimension within us which is not determined by the boundaries of our memory. Our body is a boundary of memory, our mind is a boundary of memory, but our consciousness is a dimension of intelligence which is not marked by the boundaries of memory. Unless people touch this dimension, you can talk about unity, you can talk about togetherness as much as you want as principles and values, but never will it work unless human beings experience that sense of unity. This is what the word yoga means. The word yoga literally means union. This means, right now for most human beings, their experience of life is such, it is me versus the universe. It's a stupid competition to get into. Me versus the universe. No wonder always they're anxious, fearful, struggling, simply because it is an individual versus the universal. Yoga means to consciously obliterate the boundaries of your individuality. If you don't do this, you will never come to ease in your life. Forget about well-being, forget about blissfulness, forget about ecstatic states, you will not even come to total ease. You know, I don't want to throw a challenge at you, but it is really something everybody has to check out. How many people can sit in one place with absolute ease, without any sense of any kind of stress upon them, simply by themselves, not with anybody else, just by themselves? I'm telling you, over 95% of the people cannot sit in ease in any given place, because it's always this little boundary of an individual and the universal. So raising of consciousness, this means that human being comes to ease. Only when you come to ease, you are not in a fighting mode. This fighting mode has to go. Survival for the fittest is over. Now survival is available for all of us. This is the time to put down your fighting mode and see how to do something else. And now we have wonderful things coming that everybody fears. That also I've been invited to all kinds of conferences and people, academics coming and asking me, Sadhguru, this artificial intelligence is coming, what will we do? We will lose our jobs. I said, isn't it great? We'll all be on a vacation. See, the same thing, when the machines came, I know that these things happened. When the cranes came to lift things out of the ships and stuff, all the porters' unions protested. If the machines lift the, you know, the cargo, what are we going to do? We want to carry it. So now the academics are talking the same language. If the machines do all the academic work, all the information-based work, what are we going to do? This is the same labor class now, new labor. So, this is a time when physical work and intellectual work, everything that is memory-based, data-based, is going to be done by a machine. This is the best time to raise human consciousness. And we have a window of 15 to 30 years, in my opinion, because right now, as I said earlier, because people are thinking logically, heavens are collapsing in their minds. It only existed in their minds, now it's collapsing. Because heavens are collapsing, people are tending to move towards all kinds of things, particularly chemical use. If you want to be healthful, there is a chemical. If you want to be peaceful, there is a chemical. If you want to be joyful, there is a chemical. If you want to be blissful, there is a chemical. If you want to be ecstatic, of course, there is ecstasy. So, people are moving towards chemicals. Just leave the rest of the world. In India alone, in the last 25 years, the consumption of alcohol has gone up at least 10,000%. Yes or no? It has. So, this is not a moral issue for me. What I'm saying is, once 90% of humanity goes on chemicals to keep their well-being, after that you can't talk to them. And the next generation that you produce will be less than yourself. If we make this happen, that the next generation we produce is less than us, this is a crime against humanity as far as I'm concerned, because the next generation has to be at least one step ahead of us, otherwise we have fundamentally failed as a generation. So this is our time on the planet. We have the highest level of comfort and convenience that any generation has ever known. Are we also going to be the greatest generation ever? This is the question before all of us. And we have the necessary means and technologies and capabilities to make this happen. The question is only, do we have the courage and commitment to walk this distance? That's what I'm trying to invigorate the world to.